Namaskaram, sir.
Yes.
I'm Nishant Vidyarthi. I'm an MA German student. I'm an activist, like environment activist in our campus in JNU.
And my question is, what should be the Hindu approach to political agitation and solution for the environment or Mother Nature? Like, is there any plan of action for this? And why can't we have more environment activists so that the narratives are not to be imported from the West, like Greta, you know?
Because I think in the Hindu mind, or at least the conservative Hindu mind, environmentalism has been entirely outsourced to the left, unfortunately, to their own detriment. You don't take a particular issue seriously, someone else is bound to. Now, whether they are doing that to protect environment, or whether they are using environment-based communities as weapons against the rest of the Hindu dharma is for people to ask. So here's what happened. So I think when this Chardham highway and all that was being discussed, and I think the road widening of Uttarakhand in Uttarakhand was being discussed. Problem is, even those who were clearly practicing conscious Hindus, when they said road widening in such an eco-sensitive region for non-defense purposes will lead to more commercialization in a fragile eco-space, we are being accused of being communists. So the discussion has now come down to these stupid binaries. I can't be a practicing Hindu, or even a Hindutvavadi for that matter, and also say nature and Prakriti are an important part of Sanatana Dharma. That lesson needs to be told to the Hindus first, more than anybody else. Because they seem to have divorced it in their heads. So that is effectively the Christianization of the Hindu belief system, where Prakriti no more features in your scheme of things. There is one thing. So in the book I have clearly said, one is to convert the Hindu. The second is to Christianize Hinduism. What has happened since 1857 is the second category, which is even more pernicious. Which is, now you look at everything about yourself through the Christian lens. So, whether this practice is rational, whether this practice is modern, why on earth are you insisting on using the word modern? Do you understand its connotations? Do you understand its origins? It has a very clear colonial anti-indigenous slant to it. Don't use it. So, I think in my limited, let's say, interactions with the public, I've said, a strong temple ecosystem translates to protection of the environment around in terms of the ponds, the lakes, and the let's say the forests around it, and forest-based communities around it. I've given some examples. How certain mathas depend on tribal communities exclusively for their, let's say, for the wood that is needed to keep their kitchens burning without resorting to modern kitchenry, so to speak, to ensure that there is a livelihood there, there's a continuity here, so on and so forth. Are there any PhDs in this country actually focusing on the relationship between a strong temple ecosystem and conservation of nature? Maybe you should seriously consider one of those topics. There is enough to research on. I am giving anecdotes, but I don't think even my position is as rigorous. My first principle position may be rigorous, but the empirical evidence is shaky because I don't know beyond this. We need more research on this. Standard go-to topics when it comes to speaking about Hindutva is conversion, religion. Theek, I think they are very important topics. But look at the other issues as well. Your agenda is primarily negative or other oriented. Let it become positive. Which means, what can you do on the education front instead of constantly crying about it? What can you do on the history front? What can you do with respect to the discussion on gender identities before it succumbs to woke garbage? That's the next massive worst, let's say, export from the United States, which you will see extremely wary of. It's even worse than radioactive uranium. Because it's going to kill every societal structure within. And teach us about how to treat the non-gender binary identity. I mean, non-binary gender identity. Come on, don't teach us. We have deities who are actually in that particular Tritiya Prakriti. and there are communities and spaces where they are protected. All of that will be repackaged with a lot of anger. And the standard Marxist oppressive trope, and will be told, no, this is all about, from caste-based patriarchy, it will now translate to gender-based, let's say caste-based oppression, it will now translate to gender-based oppression. I would genuinely hope that our to-do list expands. I have enough to do already, man. How much will I do? See, whatever I have, my limited role has been knowing fully well how the other side operates. Yes, there is another side. If this translates to otherization, I'm sorry, it already exists. That is the reality which I live in. I know how it operates in my fraternity. So nobody is in a position to pontificate me about otherization. So since that exists, how do you make sure that you have a very clear positive agenda? It's not in the interest of...